Hello students, good morning. I hope you all are doing good. And today once again, I, Divyanshi Srivastav, is here before you with a new lesson of literature. This is one of the chapters from our textbook, that is Dreamcatcher, the reader that we are using. And the chapter's name is Mrs. Packletide's Tiger. Mrs. Packletide's Tiger is a story which is written by Saki. He's the writer. In this entire story, what the writer wants to narrate, what is the theme of the poem, what are the character specifications, what is the whole content, what is the gist, what is the summary of this entire chapter, that we will be studying in this video. So let's continue. Okay, before anything else, let's study the theme, because in every story or in any part of literature, theme is very important. This will give you a rough idea that what is actually you're going to learn in this entire chapter. So the first theme of this chapter is jealousy. Okay, now talking about jealousy, why is jealousy one of the themes of this specific chapter is because you will find two ladies are there, that is Mrs. Packletide and Luna Bimerton. Both of these ladies, okay, they are carrying this attribute in them, which is the jealousy. They are jealous of each other. Then the second part is pride. Now why pride is mentioned? Because both of these ladies, they are full of pride that they are more renowned. Because they were so renowned in the society, that's why they were so prideful of themselves, that the deeds they made, it was so, they were boosting upon that deeds that was made by them. Then the insecurity. Insecurity is because obviously they are jealous of each other, so they are insecure that one day if Luna Bimerton is going to rise up, that is if she is going to be more renowned, then definitely Mrs. Packletide is not going to hold that same position. She is going to come down. So this is a sense of insecurity that each other, like they were having this competition among themselves that one should not go in front, like one should not hit above that line. Both of them should either be equal or they should, like the one should be below that very specific person. Then control. Control and selfishness. These two themes are used for the rest of the character, that is the villagers that is being used in this specific story. Because selflessly, I cannot say exactly selflessly, but still they were carrying that passion to work for that work that was assigned by Mrs. Packletide to these villagers. Then blackmail. Blackmail is basically used over here because in the last of this chapter you will find that there is the assistant whose name is Miss Mebbin. Okay, she is trying to just catch this lady, Mrs. Packletide, in some or the other way and get what she wants. She wants to extract the jewel, the very house that she was looking for with Mrs. Packletide. Okay, now the next thing, that is your character. Now we'll learn that what are the different characters that is used in this specific chapter. The first character is Luna Bimerton. Okay, now when we talk about Luna Bimerton, she is also known as Miss Bimerton. She is a assistant of Mrs. Packletide. Who is she? She is the assistant, the secretary who used to work for her. Now, the next character is Luna Bimerton. Luna Bimerton is one of the big shots in the society. That's the reason why Mrs. Packletide and Luna Bimerton, they always had a tough fight for being more renowned than the villagers. Villagers are those people who used to stay in the nearby place. Then Mrs. Packletide, one of the most important characters in this entire story. She is even one of the renowned characters. Then the Algerian aviator. Algerian aviator is not another than the pilot with whom Luna Bimerton flew for 11 miles. She was the fellow, like this Algerian aviator, he was the very pilot who flew the flight that Luna Bimerton was seated on. Now, let's continue with the story. It was Mrs. Packletide's pleasure and intention that she should shoot a tiger. Not that the lust to kill had suddenly descended on her, or that she felt that she would leave India safer and more wholesome than she had found it. With one fraction less of wild beasts per million on inhabitants, the compelling motive for her sudden deviation towards the footsteps of Nirmod was the fact that Luna Bimerton had recently been carried 11 miles in an aeroplane by an Algerian aviator and talked of nothing else, only a personally pronounced tiger skin and a heavy harvest to press photographs could successfully counter that sort of thing. Okay, now see, in this paragraph, what has been narrated? In the starting of it, it is said that it was Mrs. Packletide's pleasure and intention. This means that it was nothing like killing. See, in this picture, as you can see, that Mrs. Packletide, for example, just imagine that this lady with the green hat, she is Mrs. Packletide. So she wanted to kill a tiger. And she didn't wanted to kill a tiger because she was looking for a safer India. That means she doesn't wanted to kill a tiger to protect the population or to protect the civilians of India with this tiger. But she wanted to kill a tiger to satisfy her own pleasure and intention. Why? For the reason being, this lady, Mrs. Packletide, she was highly jealous with the popularity, with the renown of Luna Bimerton. Okay, Luna Bimerton is again the similar character to it, and she was renowned for the reason because she had been carried 11 miles in an aeroplane by an Algerian aviator. Okay, there was the reason why she was so famous, and the reason was because she flew 11 miles in an aeroplane. So this lady, Mrs. Packletide, she became jealous of Luna Bimerton because now the people all around the society, they were talking about Luna Bimerton only. No one was having any chat, any count on Mrs. Packletide. That's the reason what it was, that she was highly jealous to it. She was very uncomfortable in her own skin. So just to give her a tough fight, just to give Luna Bimerton a tough fight, what did Mrs. Packletide thought of? To kill a tiger. Okay, and now nothing else she wanted, but she just wanted a press photograph. She wanted that with the tiger skin, her photograph should be there. So there was a reason why she wanted to kill it. Then Mrs. Patterside had already arranged in her mind the lunch she would give at her house in Curzon Street in Luna Bimerton's honor with a tiger skin rug. Okay, now tiger skin rug, as you can see, a tiger carpet spread on this floor, as you can see in this photograph. Okay, so this is known as your tiger skin rug. The carpet, it's nothing else but the carpet that you spread in your home. Then, occupying most of the foreground and all of the conversation, she had also already designed in her mind the tiger claw brooch that she was going to give Luna Bimerton on her next birthday. In a world that is supposed to be chiefly spent by hunger and by love, Mrs. Patterside was an expectation. Her movements and motives were largely governed by the dislike of Luna Bimerton. Now see, in the last line, as it is mentioned that Mrs. Patterside was an expectation, and her movements and motives, this means whatever the actions or whatever the deeds this lady, Mrs. Patterside, used to perform, it was because whatever the intentions or whatever the motives or whatever the movements, like suppose even if she wants to purchase something, okay, that even was partially dependent, like I will not say completely, but yes, it was partially dependent on how Luna Bimerton will react on it, or will she like it or not. It was completely being governed by these intentions. And what did this lady, Mrs. Patterside, had in her mind? That she's going to kill a tiger. And then the second thing, what will she do with that tiger skin? She's going to get a carpet. She'll be getting a carpet made up of that very tiger skin. And the second thing that she had in her mind was that she will give Luna Bimerton a brooch, and that too a brooch of the tiger claw, on the next birthday, so that she could prove that this Mrs. Patterside, she is more brave, she is more bold than Luna Bimerton. She wanted to show down Luna Bimerton. That's the reason why she was doing all these things. Now, circumstances proved propitious. Propitious means favorable. Mrs. Patterside had offered 1,000 rupees for an opportunity of shooting a tiger without over much risk or exertion. And it so happened that a neighboring village could also boast of being the favored residence of an animal of respectable ancestors, which had been driven by the increasing infirmity's age to abdomen game killing and confine its appropriate to the smaller domestic animals. The prospect of earning the 1,000 rupees had stimulated the sporting and the commercial instincts of the villagers. Children were posted day and night on the outskirts of the local jungles on head the tiger back in the unlikely event of his attempting to the room, away to the flesh, to the fresh hunting ground, and the cheaper kinds of goats were left about with elaborate carelessness to keep him satisfied with his present quarrel. Now see, what is happening over here? As you can see that this lady, okay, suppose in the first picture, as you can see that Mrs. Patterside, just imagine that this is Mrs. Patterside, okay, and these are rest of the villagers. So what is she doing? She had, see, in the first part I have discussed this, that Mrs. Packletide had this thing in her mind that she wanted to kill a tiger, but she didn't knew how to kill a tiger, and by her own self she couldn't kill a tiger. So what did she did? She took the help of these villagers. And what did she offer these villagers? She took out a 1,000 rupee note and she said that whosoever is going to get me the tiger and whosoever is going to help me in killing that tiger, I will give that very individual a 1,000 rupee note. Okay. So now, when this offer was being proposed in front of these villagers, they were very much fascinated. They were very much energized because the amount was quite big with their expectation. The amount that Mrs. Packletide was offering was quite big as these villagers could expect. So, as it is given that the 1,000 rupee had stimulated the sporting and commercial instincts of the villagers. This means the sporting quality. Sporting means the hunting quality. They stimulated this 1,000 rupee note. When they saw that note, when they heard about that very offer, okay, the instinct, this means the quality of killing, the quality of hunting, okay, this generally it got just stimulated. This means that it got generated in these villagers. And what did they did? They asked their children. They got their children on duty. And how did they help Mrs. Packletide? Let's learn about that thing. Mothers carrying their babies home through the jungle after the day's work in the field hush their singing, lest they might curtail the restful sleep of the venerable herd dropper. The great night dully arrived, moonlight and cloudless. A platform had been constructed in a comfortable and conveniently placed tree, and the serum crushed Mrs. Packletide and her paid companion, Mrs. Mebbit. Okay, Miss Mebbit. Now see, what happened over here? These villagers, what they used to do, they used to look after this tiger. They found an old and weak tiger. And what they did is, the villagers, they started making this tiger comfortable. Now, they had to make a lot of effort. Why? Because this very tiger, he was weak and he was very old. So there was a sense of insecurity in this tiger, in this villagers even. So that it may happen, because this tiger, he was weak and he was old, so it may happen that this tiger may die before the day when Mrs. Packletide would kill. So what they used to do, they used to make this tiger comfortable. They used to feed. Okay, and they do not, even the lullabies means lori. Okay, lori sunte na, raat mein jab mummy sunati hain bachcho ko, that time lori ko hum kehte hain English mein lullaby. So these lullabies were narrated in a very soft and gentle manner so that the tiger's sleep is not being disturbed. Then finally, when that day arrived, that moonlight and cloudlessness day arrived, okay, at that time what happened, that a very comfortable platform, as you can see in the second picture, that on the tree itself a platform was built for Miss Mebbin as well as for Mrs. Packletide, so that they can comfortably sit over there and kill the tiger as per their needs. Then, even, you know, killing of the tiger was full of strategy. It was just not like this that they had just offered to kill, but they were killing that tiger even with a strategy. And what was the strategy of killing this tiger was, a goat gifted with particularly persistent bleat, such as even a partially deaf tiger might be reasonably expected to hear on a still night was littered at the correct distance with an accurately signed rifle and a thumbnail pack of patient scars. The sportswomen awaited the coming of the quarry. Okay, now see what is happening over here. Now with this tiger, okay, when this tiger was placed at this place to be killed, because this tiger was very old, okay, and they didn't had anything in their mind, so what did they did? They kept a goat. You can see this goat over here. What did they did? Just to attract the intention, just to attract the tiger towards themselves, okay, what did this villagers did? They tied a goat nearby the tiger, so that when this tiger will see this goat, he will come to eat this goat, and at that time only this lady will shoot. Now what happened after this? She was not actually nervous about the wild beast, but she had a mortal dread of performing an act of more service than she had been paid for. Now see, who is being talked about, like whom the writer is talking about? It's about Miss Mebbin. Now Miss Mebbin is a paid companion. This means that she is a lady who was being paid. Why? Because she was the secretary of this lady, Mrs. Tackleside. And this Miss Mebbin, she had a quality of showing the self that she cared about Mrs. Tackleside a lot. What did she have? This thing was there in her that she always wanted to show Mrs. Tackleside that she was a well-wisher of Mrs. Tackleside. Miss Mebbin always wanted to show Mrs. Tackleside that she was a well-wisher of Mrs. Tackleside. And that's why she is making such sort of a statement over here that it may happen that this wild beast may kill you. What is she saying? What is she trying to do over here? She is not nervous, but still she is trying to show her overprotective attitude just to convince Mrs. Tackleside that she is a good companion, she is a faithful servant. Then, if it is an old tiger, I think you ought to get a cheaper. 1,000 rupees is a lot of money. Now what is she trying to do over here? She's saying that this tiger is so old, then why are you wasting 1,000 rupee note? You would have given a cheaper amount and that would have even been good. That would have even been satisfied. Then she says, Mebbin adopted a protective elder sister attitude towards the money in general, irrespective of nationality or domination. Now, I told you this before that she had this character, she had this inbuilt character in her to show that she was very protective towards Mrs. Tackleside. But actually she was not protective because she was the one who had blackmailed her. Now, her energetic invention had saved many a rubble. Now see, rubble is a Russian momentary unit. Like, ruble is basically the, as in India we use, it's actually, ruble is the currency of Russia. As we use Indian currency is rupee, right? In a similar manner, the Russian currency is ruble. For dissipating itself in tip in some Moscow hotel, the fantric and the cementin clung. Now, these are again the momentary units for the several European countries. To her insensitively under circumstances which would have driven them headlong from the less sympathetic hat, her speculation as to the market depreciation of the tiger, remnant were cut short by the appearance of the scene of the wildlife. As soon as I caught sight of the threatened goat, it lay flat on the earth, seemingly led from the desire to take advantage to all available cover than for purpose to snatch a short rest before commencing the grand attack. I believe it's ill, says Louis Mebbin, loudly in Hindustan. For the benefit of the village headman, who was the ambush in the neighboring tree, not me. The headman of this village, he was even seated just near the tree. Now what happened? Now if they are completely set to kill a tiger, and now what happened over here, that there is a shot that is being released. Matlab, this is a gun. See, as you can see, this lady with the red hat, she is carrying a gun. So now what she has done, she has already shot. One shot of bullet has been released from her gun. Now, hush, said Mrs. Packletide. At that moment, the tiger commenced ambling towards his victim. Now, urged Miss Mebbin, with some excitement, if he doesn't touch the goat, we needn't pay for it. The rifle flashed out with a loud report, and the great tawny beast sprang out one side and then rolled over the stillness of death. In a moment, a crowd of excited natives had swarmed on the scene, and their shouting speedily carried the glad news to the village. Their tumbling of tom-toms took up the crotch of triumph, and the triumph and rejoicing found a ready echo in the heart of Mrs. Packletide. Already at the Lantern's party in Curzon Street seemed immeasurably nearer. Now see, what happened over here? This lady, Miss Mebbin, what is she saying? That firstly, so she said that the tiger is old, then why are you paying 1,000 rupee note? Then secondly, she says to say that if this tiger is not going to touch this goat, or if this tiger is not going to die, then we are not going to pay that 1,000 rupee to this villager. These villagers, they are not going to invest our 1,000 rupee note at all. We'll be saving that rupee if this tiger is not dead. But still, Mrs. Packletide didn't focus much, and what did she do? She shot a bullet. Now, once she shot a bullet, what happened over here? That this tiger was even killed, and even the goat was killed at the same time. Now, when this tiger rolled to death, matlab, when this tiger was dead, at that time, what happened? The villagers, they started rejoicing. And while they were rejoicing, what happened? The gladness, that very echo of their rejoice, their triumph, their victory, it even boosted the heart of Mrs. Packletide. But now see, there is a twist that appears over here. And that is that Mrs. Packletide had killed a goat instead of killing a tiger. Now see, what happened over here is that this lady, okay, when she shot a bullet, at that time she killed a goat. Now when the bullet was released, the very appropriate, like the target was not that appropriate, so the bullet had hit the goat and she was dead. Okay, now the next thing out over here is both of them are dead. The tiger is even dead, as well as the goat is even dead. So what is happening over here is there is a mystery that how come the tiger and the goat, both of them are dead at the same time. So now one thing arises over here is that if the goat is being shot, if she is the one who is wounded, then how come the tiger is dead? So the tiger was dead with the sound of the bullet, because we know that the tiger was very old and he was even very weak. So the sound of the bullet only made this tiger cause that death. Now, everyone was rejoicing, but the fact was unveiled. This means that the villagers and Miss Nevin knew this thing. They had this thing in their mind. They knew the fact that the tiger was not being killed, but the goat was killed. But these villagers, they kept quiet. They didn't say anything. They didn't utter anything. But they kept quiet over there. And why did they kept quiet? Because they were getting the 1,000 rupee loan. And if they would have protested against this thing that Miss Patricide has killed a goat instead of killing a tiger, then they wouldn't have received that 1,000 rupee note. So this was the reason why they kept quiet. Now the second thing what happened over here was this reason gave a big purpose for Miss Nevin to blackmail Mrs. Patricide. For the reason being, because she wanted a cottage. She wanted a cottage which was near Duckling. Okay, so what did she did? Miss Nevin, she blackmailed Mrs. Patricide to get her the very cottage, or else she will unveil the mystery in front of Luna Bimerton that Mrs. Patricide has killed a tiger instead of killing a goat. And it's all the humor which is being spread. It's all lies. Nothing is true. She is not that goat. So at last what happens is that just to keep this secret as a secret, Mrs. Patricide, she has to give the amount, the 600 rupees to Miss Nevin so that she could buy that cottage and this mystery could stay as a mystery. So I hope, students, this chapter is clear to you. If there is any doubt, you can drop it in the comment section. Thank you.